Well, hi, hello, my dear students. Welcome to my video lecture class. Right up to now, I uploaded a few video lectures on the topic circular motion. Please watch previous lecture for better understanding. So now, today we are going to start my session with the applications of linear momentum. So this is very important while solving numericals in competitive exam. Like JEE and NEET, these applications are very helpful. So please watch the lecture till the end. Definitely you'll get a clear idea. Applications of linear momentum. So applications of linear momentum. First application number one. Let us consider a body of mass m. And it is moving with velocity v, and hits the wall. It is moving with velocity v and hits the wall, then comes to rest. Find the change in momentum of a body. So please read the application once again. Let us consider a body of a mass m. It is moving with velocity v and hits the wall, then comes to rest. Find the change in momentum of a body. So here I consider wall. So here I consider a body. So this is one body I consider. This is moving with velocity. This having mass m. It is moving with velocity v. And it hits the wall. Once it hits the wall, it comes to rest. Okay, so comes to rest. This is a v1 is equal to v is given, v2 is equal to 0. So it hits the wall and comes to rest means v2 is equal to 0. Initially it is moving with velocity v and hits the wall, it comes to rest. Okay, so now change in momentum delta p bar is equal to, few minutes back I discussed in last lecture. So delta p bar is equal to pf bar minus pi bar. Well, change in momentum delta p bar is equal to pf bar minus pi bar. So here how to find pf bar? So after hitting all parameters are nothing but final parameters. Before hitting, the parameters are initial parameters. Here observe carefully, pf means m into v2 bar minus m into v1 bar. Okay, pi means m into v1 bar, because final velocity is what? V2 is final velocity. Initial velocity is what? V. Initial velocity is V1 bar. Okay, what is the velocity here? Observe carefully. So you are all already know the directions. So this is north direction. This is south direction. This is east direction. This is west direction. In the east direction, body is moving along east direction. In this direction, we take I cap. Body is moving in west direction, we take minus I cap. Body is moving along north direction, we take J cap. Body is moving along south direction, we take minus J cap. Okay. Body moving along east direction, we take I cap. Body moving west direction, we take minus I cap. Body is moving along north direction, J cap. Body is moving south direction, we take minus J cap. Substitute here. Observe carefully. Here the body is moving along east direction. So that's why we consider direction is I cap. Direction is I cap. So here velocity is V. That means M into V I cap. M into V I cap minus. So observe carefully. Final velocity. V2 bar is here. What is the direction of V2 bar? West direction. Direction of V2. This is final value. Direction of velocity vector V2 is west direction. West direction means, so we are taking minus I cap, M into V2 into minus I cap, okay? So minus M into V1 bar direction. What is the direction of V1 bar? Direction of V1 bar is east direction. In east direction, we take I cap. So V1 into I cap. From this, M into V2 value is 0. So already you know, minus I cap, minus M into V1 value is V into I cap. So finally what we got here, minus MV I cap. So delta P bar, direction of change in momentum. So direction of change in momentum, delta P bar is equal to minus MV I cap, minus MV I cap. So magnitude, so delta P bar, magnitude is we write like this. So magnitude means square root of minus MV whole square. So from this we got MV. So delta P bar, magnitude of change in momentum is MV. So what is this? What is the meaning for this one? So here change in momentum direction is along the west direction. So direction of P bar is along west or away from wall. Direction of P bar is along west direction or away from wall. So this is a first application of linear momentum. Okay. So next we are going to discuss second application of linear momentum. So after completion of this, we are going to discuss third application. So observe carefully this first application. Body having mass M, it is moving with velocity V. After hit the wall, it comes to rest. That means V2 value is 0. Substitute. So V1 is moving along the east direction. In east direction means positive x axis direction. That's why we are taking here I cap. But in V2 we are taking minus I cap direction. So we got finally minus MV I cap. So next application number 2. Let us consider a body of mass M. Let us consider a body of mass M. It is moving with velocity V1 bar and hits the wall, rebounds back with velocity, a V2 bar in opposite direction, then find change in linear momentum. Then find change in linear momentum. Okay, so now observe this. This is a wall I consider. So here is the body. Okay, so this body having mass m, it is moving with velocity is v1 bar. Okay, the next after hitting this wall, it rebounds back in opposite direction. So with velocity v2 bar, we need to find change in momentum. So observe here, this is a north direction, this is south direction, this is east direction, this is west direction. East direction is indicated with the I cap, west direction is indicated with the minus I cap, north direction is indicated with the J cap, south direction is minus J cap. Okay, so here body first, change in momentum, delta P bar is equal to PF bar minus PI bar. PF bar means M into V2 bar minus M into V1 bar. Okay, so M into, okay, V2 bar means, okay, so V2 bar, observe carefully, what is V2 bar direction? V2 bar is moves along negative x-axis direction, that is indicated with, west direction is indicated with minus I cap, substitute here, minus M into V1 bar is indicated with along east direction means positive x-axis, that is indicated with plus I cap. So then we got here minus M I cap, that is nothing but here V1 is indicated with V only. Both are having same speeds, I consider. If both are having same speeds, I can just consider we got VI cap here also VI cap. So from this, what we got now? MVI cap minus MVJ cap. Okay, so V1 bar and V2 bar minus MVI cap and V1 bar and V2 bar. So here, body has same velocity after bounce. So consider this. Here body has same velocity after bouncing also. That's why MV I cap minus MV J cap. MV I cap minus MV I cap. So finally what we got? Minus 2 MV I cap. Okay. Delta P bar is equal to minus 2 MV I cap. So that is direction of change in momentum is along west direction or away from what? So direction of change in momentum is along west direction or away from what? Now here, magnitude of change in momentum, delta P bar modulus is equal to square root of minus 2 mv whole square. Finally we got 2 mv. Okay, so magnitude of change in momentum is we got 2 mv. So this is a second application. So I hope you are all understood my lecture. If you will get any doubt, please mention in comment box. Again, I'll come back with newer problems and newer concepts. Okay. Thank you for supporting me and thank you for encouraging me. So again, I'll come back with new concepts. Thank you so much.